We've had a lot of changes going on within Family Search, and because of that, it gives us a great opportunity to make new videos and help explain all these wonderful new changes. So today I'm going to be focusing on a person's personal detail page. In order to get there after signing into Family Search, I can either hover over Family Tree and click on Person. That takes me into the personal detail page area, or I can actually come down to this recently viewed people area. I can click on the name of the person I want to go into their personal detail page. I can either click on their name once again or down here where it says person, and that will take me to that person's personal detail page. I've previously clicked on that and already opened it up here just for speed. So from here, I want you to know from this gray line all the way across here and down, that's what I'll be focusing on today because that is the person's personal detail page. Within this area, I will only be focusing on the detail tab. You can see that there's now a timeline, sources, collaborating, and so forth. But for the sake of time, we're just going to go over the details. So from here, if I need to change the profile of a person, I don't even have pictures of him in this computer, but if I did, I could click right here on this profile and it would give me all the different pictures that are in the memories area that I could choose from to change his portrait. I'd click on it, it might take a few minutes, or I could refresh the page and it would pop right up. So you can see that we can see when Dexter was born, when he passed away, and his personal identification number. Each person has their own number to identify them. I can come to the right, I can view them in the tree itself and see their ancestors or their descendants. I can click on watch. You can see that right now this star is clear, but if I were to click on this, that means I'm now watching him, which means Family Search will now send me weekly emails letting me know if anybody made any changes. If I don't receive the emails, nobody made any changes. I'll click unwatch because I haven't put a lot of work into him yet. Every time I work really hard on somebody, I will be watching them. I can then go view my relationship with this man. And I believe this still goes out to the first 15 generations of my ancestors. I can view my relationship. If it's 16 and beyond, I don't think this will even appear in their detail page. All right, let's go back over here on the left. I can add a life sketch to this person if I know one. Just understand that in this area, life sketches can be deleted. If you don't want things to be deleted, then put it in memories as a document or a story form. Nobody can delete memories, but you can come in here and edit and delete on this page. Down in the vitals, you can see that my cursor really doesn't give me the ability to do anything until I come to a blue edit or an add. And once I come to either one of those, I can then click into that and I can go edit or add something. So if I wanted to edit the name and I click on that, the part I really love about this is yes, I can go change the name, I can give my reason, and I like the fact that I can see how many people are watching this particular ancestor and how many people have contributed to his page. But I love the fact that I can see these 15 sources right here that are giving me evidence that this is his correct name. I love the fact that I can actually click on any of these sources, and if I scroll down, I can see the indexed portion of the original source right here, and then I can actually see the original document right here. An indexed portion is just some of the information that got taken off of the original. So you always want to go look at the original document for all of the information that's sitting there. I love how you can actually see who attached this particular source. There is no reason, but if I decided there was a really good reason, I could go in and add that to it. Okay, let me get out of this area. So I'm able to edit anything that is blue and says edit, and I can also go add. Over here, you can see this little tiny icon means that this information got standardized. So in Family Search, they're asking us to enter all our dates and places in a standard format, which means all of us need to be entering in that information with the same format so that it's all synchronized and we all understand each other's information that's being supplied. So if it doesn't have that little sign, like let me go over here and show you. Right here you can see this birth date and this birthplace is not standardized. So I would need to go edit it and make it standard, which I will be giving a completely different video on that. All right, let's keep going down on the left here. I can add other information to this person. I love the fact that I can see he was a farmer, but if I find out more information about him, I can click on add information, and I love the different areas that they allow us to add information on. So I can add alternate names or a nickname here. I can say what their religious affiliation is, any of these, I can click on and add that information. I love the fact that I can add a physical description on him because I find that all the time on military records, and that's just some fun extra information. So make sure you use this other information area to add in fun facts about your ancestor. Down here in the family area, you can see the spouses. If I click on that show all, it shows me the children to both spouses. If I don't want to see that, I can actually say hide and it shrinks the children back up. You can see that right here, this preferred is not marked, but down here it is because this is the line I come through. If I wanted to change that, all I would have to do is click on it, and that then becomes my preferred ancestor that would actually show up everywhere now in the tree and everywhere. But this is the one I want preferred. Of course, I can open up the children and look at them also. I can see the parents. You can always add another parent if he was adopted, whatever. You can add more parents, you can add more spouses to these people. You can always tell which person I'm looking at in their detail page because all of these people have blue names except one. One is black, and that's because I'm on Dexter's personal detail page. I can add his siblings from here, or I can add more children to his marriage here. Scrolling down, that's the end of it. Don't forget there's feedback. If you ever want to give feedback back to FamilySearch, they love hearing about the good or some of our struggles that we're having. Before I go over to the right, let me just show you. If I needed to get to one of Dexter's siblings or children, all I have to do is click on their name. A little summary card comes up, and I can go into their personal detail page also. Okay, let's go over here on the right. At the very top, we have Research Help. And this is where the computer finds record hints for us, which are sources that they believe really have to do with this particular ancestor, if you see it sitting on his personal detail page. But it's up to me to confirm that because it is computer generated. I really need to go make sure the computer got it right. So all I have to do is click on it. From here, if I click on Show Details right here or this Show Details, it literally takes me to the same place, which is this area. All I'm seeing is all the computer generated sources that it found, which here it's only one, and here are some research suggestions. I just wanted to show you that so you understand what this show details is. What you really want to be doing is clicking in here under this drop-down arrow, and it will actually open this area up, and I can see the indexed portion of this particular source with the original below it, if there is an original. And so I just want to suggest get in the habit, if you don't understand an area, point and click. So for instance, up here, there's three dots. Well, what's behind those three dots? If I click on it, I can add it to my source box. I can copy it. I can print it, or I can email it. To shrink that back up, I'll just click on it again. So just get in the habit of pointing and clicking. Don't be scared of messing things up because you can always undo things if you do mess anything up or somebody will fix it for you. Next, we have this record collection area. If I were to click on the title of this collection, it would give me the ability to come in here and add first and last names, or I can fill in any of this information to go search for one of my ancestors within this collection. If I come over to this little I, if I just hover over it, you can see it's talking about the wiki page. If I were to click on it, it would jump me right into the wiki page, which is just a huge genealogical, like, encyclopedia. It's absolutely amazing. And the way we can actually get to it, let me come back to this page. The other way we can get to the wiki is if I hover over search, and well, I'm going to guess I'm going to have to exit out of this. If I hover over search and go down to Research Wiki, that's another way to get to it. But it's a place where if you ever need to learn something to do with genealogy, jump into the wiki and type in your search engine there, and you can spend hours learning about genealogical items. Down below, document information. If I were to click on that, it gives me the GS film number and the digital folder number and other information. And often that is so helpful when you literally need to dive in and find an ancestor with that film number. And that would be a whole nother lesson in itself. The last thing is reviewing and attaching this document to my ancestor. So if I click on review and attach, it brings me to the source linker. At this point, I would click on compare. I would open this up and I would determine whether this document, which sits on the left, is the same as my person that is in my tree. If it is, I would attach it, and I will be giving a completely different video on how to attach sources to your ancestors. The next area is research suggestions, and when you click on that, it just gives you what the computer feels like could be missing with things that are kind of going wrong with this personal detail page. Like here, they're saying that, you know, there might be more children that are within this family because there's quite a big gap there between them. All right, next we have search records. So Family Search, Ancestry, Find My Past, and My Heritage are all websites that allow us to go look for sources that have to do with our ancestors, and we can actually take a copy of that and attach it to our ancestor if we find some. So basically, these four different websites, they have birth certificate, death certificates, military records, census records, so many, I cannot list them right now. But once again, we'll give future videos just in this area right here so you can learn how to find documents, which then will give us the information that will give us enough evidence to fill out the vitals of our ancestor. Latest changes. If I click on any of these blue titles or down on show all, it takes me to the exact same place, and it's going to give me a list. I think I have it open right here. Yes, it gives me a list of all the different attaching or detaching sources and relationships and things that have happened to my family member. And some of them I can go click on them and learn more about it. Some of them you can actually restore if somebody did something you're not happy with, which I don't see that ability right here, but this is just a place to go see what's been happening on your ancestor. All right, the next one is tools. In here you have the ability to what they call edit labels. Now a label is, let me come up here to this man. This Nauvoo Citizens and this company here is a label. And what that means is that my ancestor belonged to the Nauvoo Citizens, and he also was a part of that pioneer company. The way you attach those is if you click on edit labels and attach labels. Well, of course, first you're going to have to make sure your ancestor really was a part of this company or the group that you're going to attach him to, but then you just click on it and say attach. So these different labels are well-known groups or historical events that your ancestor may have been a part of. The next area is possible duplicates. Because we work in a website with people all over the world, all working in together, oftentimes we create the same person and they end up in this tree together. And I may be working here in America on my ancestors, and somebody may be working in Scotland on the exact same ancestors, and we both enter the same person and it creates a duplicate. Or they've already been in the system for years anyways, but you would be seeing a number over here if the computer found a duplicate. But I'm going to be giving a specific lesson on duplicates because this is a huge, important matter that we got to work through. And so you can also merge duplicates by ID if you find that two of your ancestors are literally the same people. You can report abuse if you feel like something is not happening the way it should on a person's personal detail page with your ancestor. You can go report that. Here you can't delete people. The only way you can delete anymore is if you add them, nobody's touched the page that you've added, you can delete them. But the second somebody else goes in and attaches information about them, you can no longer delete them. You can merge people, but not delete. And then you have all the printing functions of pedigrees, fan charts, and so forth. The only thing I think I forgot to mention here was next to our ancestors' relationships, there's a pencil, and you can edit the relationships. Like here, I would be able to edit the marriage, and maybe if I had the wrong spouse, I could edit the spouse. Next to each child, there's a pencil. So literally, when you click on that, you have the ability to go in and I can remove or replace the father, I can remove or replace the child, and so forth. So just be aware that every person you add to the tree, you can actually edit them or their relationships. I'm so sorry this video was so long, but that was a lot to get through. Thanks for joining me.